armed with that, let's now talk about how firms make short-run production decisions. So let's start by considering the short run and considering that period of time over which labor is variable but capital is fixed. Okay? Labor is variable but capital is fixed. That is, you have a given plant, but you can adjust how many workers you use every day in that plant. Okay. And now the firm has to decide, given that that plant exists, how many workers should I hire to produce my good? How many workers should I hire to produce my good? And the key concept that's going to determine that is something we'll call the marginal product of labor. The marginal product of labor. Okay? Which is the change in total output resulting from the next unit of labor used. That is delta Q, delta L. Okay? Is the marginal product of labor. It's going to be the change in total output from another unit of labor, once again holding capital constant, because that's fixed. Okay, so really, I shouldn't have to, it's really at a given K bar. But that's implicit in the fact this is short run. So at a given level of capital, what is the change in output for another unit of labor? And once again, it's short run, I shouldn't have to write this. If I tell you short run, you should know this is true. But technically, we would write that out. Okay? Now, what we're going to do here is we're typically going to assume, just as we typically, this hint, hint, if you're comfortable with consumer theory, this is like margin utility. Marginal product is like margin utility. Just as the margin utility was your utility from another unit of one good, holding the other good fixed, marginal product is the marginal production from another unit of an input, holding the other input fixed. Okay? So just sort of a parallel to keep in mind. Okay? And just as we assumed and discussed the intuition for diminishing margin utility, we're going to typically assume diminishing marginal product. Okay? So we're going to assume diminishing marginal product. That is, from a given level of labor, the next worker you add increases your product, your total product, by less than the previous one. Now, once again, just like we have a non-satiation rule in utility, we're not going to say the next worker doesn't help. Every worker helps. But every worker helps less and less and less, just like every pizza means less and less and less to you. The intuition for why each worker does less, I find, is a little bit harder. I mean, you could say, well, gee, why should one worker do less than the next worker? Why should the next worker do less than the first? Okay? And the key is this part, that we're holding capital constant. The reason each worker does less is because they only have the same amount of stuff to work with. Okay? And the classic example we use here is the example of digging a hole. Okay, where the capital is, you go to dig a hole and your capital is a shovel. And let's say for some reason the shovels are out, so you can't get another shovel for a while. Okay, so there's one shovel. So you have one worker digging a hole. Okay, then the next worker comes along, and the next worker can help because he can spell the first worker. Okay? And maybe the next worker is just as good because you can work more hours, but probably it's a little bit less good. But certainly by the time you had a fourth and a fifth and a sixth person with one shovel, they probably each help because they can rotate and rest each other. But certainly the sixth person is not going to help dig the hole as much as that second person did, or the third or fourth or fifth person, because there's only one shovel. Okay? So they can share a little bit and share the burden a little bit, but at some point each additional worker helps less because they have to share the same shovel. So that's why it's diminishing marginal product, is because capital's fixed. With a certain amount of capital to work with, each additional worker just can't help as much as the one before. Okay? Now eventually you can add more shovels. And you can have wheelbarrows. So some people could run the wheelbarrows, some people could run the shovels. But that's the long run. In the short run, there's the one shovel. So each additional worker does less good.